Welcome to Uniti Update episode 15.
We're in the world's largest city, Tokyo, Japan. We're here in Tokyo, Japan, one of the extremely densely populated areas of the world, where pollution and cars in the city is a real problem that we want to fix. And that's why we've been invited to a conference where Lewis is going to talk about cars' role in the city. Because Uniti is really designed and perfect for cities like Tokyo. It's smaller, lightweight, and it really fits the format of the city.
So before we go to the conference that we've been invited to and where Lewis is going to have his speech, we thought it'd be a great idea to go out on the streets and see what the citizens of Tokyo feel about our car and how they would feel about it driving around in their city. So I think we should go and see what they have to say. Hello, excuse me?
これ?
Yeah?
Gutto, gutto.
Electric. Battery only. Looks like good. 300 kilometers. Oh, wow. Fantastic. My which I want. I need this. This one. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Woo-hoo. You like electric cars?
Yes.
Yes?
good design.
What do you think about this electric car here that we do from Uniti?
Very good.
Nah, kind of quiet guy.
It has like that electric, like that futuristic look. I think it's like the way to go.
Could you see this car in Tokyo, for example?
Yeah, I feel like it would like blend in with like the city. It'll be a really nice car.
Uniti City?
Yes.
This car?
Yes.
Did you like it?
So-so.
Can we ask you some questions? It's a Swedish electric car from Sweden.
It's good design.
Yeah? Thank you.
Thank you!
So apparently, you can see Tokyo has a big problem with congestion and finding parking lots. It's a car elevator. It goes up into the building instead of having parking lots along the streets. Yeah.
Very smart and compact, right?
And how do you think about compact cars and two-seaters?
For only my own, I want to ride a two-seater. Of course.
Would you buy a car like this?
Yeah, in the future.
Would you see this car in a few years driving around in the cities of Japan?
I hope so.
Do you own a car?
I do.
Is it an electric car?
Yeah, electric.
Can I ask you what you think about the car Uniti? Thank you.
Uniti is Swedish.
What do you think about the design?
Design good. Good.
Design and color very good.
How do you feel about electric cars?
Very important.
I'm designer. Very stylish.
Uniti is Swedish.
So we're here at Tokyo Motor Show where we're checking out some new vehicles and different cars and also meeting some new interesting partners and industry leaders and just getting a contact for production and different technologies. So behind us here, there's also some vehicle concept that they're driving around in a made with VR, and it looks really, really cool.
And in just a few hours, our CEO Lewis is going to have a speech over here. And before that, we thought we'd take the time to show you around a bit here and see what cool stuff we can find. Just a short little note here. This car looks oddly familiar to our old concept.
Uniti Sweden 社 CEO ルイス・ホーン様にご講演いただきます。
So, what should it be, this new car or this new approach to mobility? I, for one, think that in city centers, electricity is the best thing to drive our mobility. There are many different technologies, but it's electric that we can convert in the most efficient manner from energy to exergy. The size must also make sense. We have two products that we're going to launch on December 7th, a two-seater and a four-seater, and sometimes journalists say it's small. But I always like to say, well, perhaps the other ones are too large. When I go to Singapore, for example, they have no more space for new cars and a population that is growing, yet still you have a great big two-ton car with one driver and the same usage pattern every day. Are those cars not too big? The vehicle, as said, will be launched on December 7th in the south of Sweden in our new production space. If you want to come to that event, just check our website. Thank you very much for your time. Arigato.
So that was Lewis's speech here at the event, and we've got super great response on our design, as you saw, and Lewis's speech. The Tokyo Motor Show was super fun.
I thought we asked Lewis what he felt about the speech and the vibe.
I thought the Japanese people in general were just super open and positive and friendly. I think it's very clear that our vehicle could work here. I mean, obviously it would fit in the city logically. Because they have many of the same congestion issues and so forth as Europe and anywhere else. But also I think aesthetically and in terms of culture it would really fit well. You know, they love the high-tech thing. And even way back in the original design phase, even right down to the logo, it was always designed to be directly compatible or appealing to markets like Japan.
Your life in general must be pretty interesting at these times. What's it like to be you right now?
You know, I gotta focus very hard on maintaining my health, because it's quite regular that I, like this last night, I randomly have an opportunity for 2 hours of sleep. That's quite common. I don't really get much time to reflect on on what's going on right now, but a normal hour is like 50 different disciplines, you know, from design to product development or invention or finance or strategy. A lot of dots to connect, I don't know. It's exciting, I like it.
As an example of many dots connecting in different areas, like now when we were here in Tokyo, we got the front page of Metro back home, and they announced our production space in Landskrona. That's something to be proud of and celebrate, I think. Okay, so we're on the Shinkansen super fast bullet train.
It's a really cool trip. Well, just give us a second. So we're really excited about this new space in Landskrona, where we're also going to have our launch event and our future production.
Yeah, and you're going to see a lot more about this space in the coming episodes, and it's going to be really awesome.
Now, how is it going with the car? As you all know, we have to build an autonomous electric car for the launch event. So now there's been a lot of parts arriving, and we've been starting to put them all together, and the car is really starting to take shape. We have a lot of people working day and night in the building and a lot of external support helping us out.
I'm dry fitting the rear swoop. Dry fitting means we test assemble it before it's sent to upholstery, so we know it all comes together nicely. And this is the rear swoop, the padding behind the passenger, more or less.
But there's been a twist. Now we don't have to build just one car, but we have to build three. We can't tell you why right now, so you're going to have to stay tuned for the coming updates.
So thank you for watching another Uniti Update episode, and we hope you enjoyed it. We will make another one soon, and until then, have a nice day and thank you for watching.
Hi, we just thought we'd take this moment to tell you that usually trips like this are paid by the sponsor of the event. So to all our crowd investors out there, we're spending your money wisely. Thank you for watching.